Hello, Ritas Tolvis. I'm Damien Halme, your guide to the mother of all languages, featured on HBO's Game of Thrones, High Valyrian.
Valyria Munioengos Nuihis Issa.
This is Lesson 10, or Adjectives from the Arbor. Adjectives are every word that we use to modify or describe everything in our world. In English, adjectives always appear before the noun, unless we're trying to be very melodramatic about the way we speak.
I got passion in my pants, and I ain't afraid to show it. I'm sexy, and I'll know it.
In High Valyrian, adjectives can come either before or after the noun, depending on how you feel to flavor the sentence, with a few exceptions. Words like a or the, we call these determiners, and words like that or this, we call these words demonstratives. These always come before the noun in High Valyrian. Valyrian adjectives are way easier than nouns, with only half the flavors, two of which are easy peasy. The only difficulty with adjectives is they must match the noun in both case and gender. Let's delve into those three flavors of adjectives. Flavor number one, the all flavor. Many adjectives have only two variants across the four genders. The all flavor has different endings for each, though. That's why it's called all. Using this chart, you just find what the noun is you want to modify, and use the adjective's matching ending. If you choose to put the adjective after the noun, you have to use the letters in parentheses. If it comes before the noun, shorten it by lopping the parenthetical part off. Now that you know the word for dirty, Vaugenka, you can talk dirty to me.
Talk dirty to me.
Flavor number two, soft. Mele, or red, is an example of the soft flavor. This style combines the lunar and solar genders into one ending set, and the terrestrial and aquatic into another. Again, the parenthetical parts are only if the adjective comes after the noun. Dies and sus are the nominal and accusative forms of the adjectives free and good, respectively. The rest of their charts look like all other soft types. Flavor number three, hard. The hard flavor, like soft, combines genders into two ending sets. The harder part about hard lies in their instrumental and comitative forms, where putting the adjective after the noun changes the ending more than just adding an additional letter. Where eglie becomes eglios in the instrumental before the noun, putting it after the noun changes it to egliuse, and so on. If a noun does a weird merger in its forms between two different types of declension, the adjective is going to do that too to preserve the harmony of the sound. Confused? Watch.
Watch.
Let's pick on Emilia Clarke's favorite word from the series, Dracaris. Lesson 6 tells us it's solar gender because it ends in S, and Lesson 8 puts this in the celestial flavor because it specifically ends in YS. If you look at most instrumental endings, you'll see them end in OSA, OSY, something with an S, but solar celestials end in OMY, Dracaromi. Identical to the comitative ending. To say red dragon fire in the instrumental form, like she slays with red dragon fire, we would expect to say ziri dracoromi melose o senza. But to make everything pretty, we match the weird solar celestial ending in the adjective and say ziri dracoromi melome o senza. Hear the synergy? That's it for this lesson. Next up, we're gonna take a pause on lessons for a little bit and teach you all some really great Game of Thrones phraseology. Who's ready to start speaking like a true Valyrian? Try this. Kirim vose. Please like or subscribe and I'll keep the Valyrian train a-chuggin'. Check out A Wicked Bison Fire or Dothraki.org, wonderful places to learn more about the series, or connect with the forums community at Westeros.org, where those people have been keeping it partying like 1999 was when winter was coming. Quiero silas!